Welcome back to Wasteland 2. Let's continue in our attempts to save Hypool from the invaders. So we've just left the store where Jess Bell was. Wants us to get her dowry back that her dad lost in a gambling accident, if you can call it that. More like an act of stupidity, I think is probably more accurate. Alright, looks like all the action's probably up there, but what's down here? Oh. Somebody see something. A lock and a trap, okay. I wonder, can you picklock it before disabling the trap? Are those independent? Or would you trigger the trap by trying to lockpick it? I just said picklock, didn't I? Picklock, lockpick, whatever. What's the difference? Alright. Disable that trap. Oh, it's very simple. Crack that thing. Oh, wait, what did that say? That's not great. Hold on, do I have any saved up character points for him? Skill points? One. That's not enough to upgrade lockpicking. And that's with lockpicking at level 2. Wow. Whatever. Let's do it. 10% chance of critical failure is not too bad. Excellent. Good job, Harper. I'm proud of you. Ooh, there's a bunch of stuff here. Two boxes and what looks to be a safe. Ah, no mechanical tumblers or wheels accessible from the outside. Its locking mechanism appears to be controlled by a high-tech electronic system, which I believe means I can use computer science? Yeah, sweet. That's good, because that's one of the skills I don't have, is safe. The hell's it called? Safe, safe cracking, yeah. I don't have that. Although, ironically, I'm going to crack the safe, but not with... I don't really know why those are separated. I mean, I am cracking the safe, so I'm using safe cracking, but... computer science? Well, whatever. It's okay, try it again. Take your time, Harper. It's not like anybody's dying, like, 20 feet away from us. Nah. Spiked collar. It's a negative to kiss ass. But, plus one to charisma. Interesting. Okay, well I don't want to give that to Theodore. Because he does use kiss ass and charisma. It'd be good to have more charisma, but... I think he only has one in kiss ass anyway, so that would make it... Yeah, that would make it zero, which is crap. So let's give it to somebody who doesn't need to talk. I feel like the only character it would really fit would be Angela or Yulia. I don't know, a spiked collar just doesn't seem to fit a sniper or a computer hacker like Harper. Nah, let's give it to Yulia. I'm assuming that's a trinket? Yes. Oh, you can't even visually see it? Or can you? Nah, you can't. That would have been cool. Don't say anything about a trap. Okay. Excellent. Could sell that. No trap. Hopefully. Bunch of ammo. Not sure who needs it the most. I don't know. I'm not going to worry too much about ammo distribution. Until people start not being able to shoot. And then I'm going to very much worry about it. But until then, ignorance is bliss.
Where are you? I need that ammo 5 minutes ago.
There's something in here. This looks like a secret. Hello. If it wasn't for the sounds of gunshots and explosives echoing off the canyon walls, this tranquil spot would be very nice and peaceful. Oh, hello. Looks like we got a friendly here. Whoa, dude, pretty crazy energy going on here, eh? Yeah, dude. Alright, doesn't say it's explosive, but let's send Angela in. You first. Okay, it's fine. Hey man, you're welcome to whatever I have, but pay it forward, alright, compadre. A slender man with a baseball cap covering his hair and droopy eyes stirs before you. He smells like a skunk humped his leg. Crazy man, some really negative energy going on around here. It's really really messing with my chai. It's messing with his chai. What, somebody pissed in your chai? Chai. Chai. Yeah, man, you know, my energy and life force. My inner balance, man. I usually drink a cup of chai tea in the morning to keep it soft and mellow. Wait. Oh, man. I totally got that backwards, man. Chai, I mean. Or chi, man. My chi is all messed up. No, I got it backwards. You were all like, whoa, strange compadre, what are you talking about, right, man? Yeah. I was all like, my tea is all wrong, I drink my life force in the morning. Oh man, doesn't it feel good to laugh? See man, this place is a desert of happiness. Except for these record dudes. They have some really negative energy going on here and freaking me out with their explosives and stuff. Negative energy? You mean fighting? It's all wrong, man. Mercury is all retrograde and totally not happy. So I know communication isn't flowing down the communication stream of Mother Nature's life force, but these guys are really angry. They need a serious hug, man. How is a hug going to help? Man, we need to come together and love each other. We are one, man. One universe. One soul. I love you, man. I see you, man. I love and appreciate you as a soul of the universe. I love them, and they need to know that. I don't know if love will make them stop. So much negative energy, man. You need a hug, too. I can feel it. Man, it just makes me weep for humanity. I need to get out of here and free myself from this black energy. Can you help me, my dusty compadre? Okay, sure, how? My soulmate is up there in Highpool. Oh man, Highpool. What a disappointment of nomenclature, right? You know? Yeah. What was I saying? Your soulmate? Such a beautiful soul, you know? You're one, man. Yeah. Totally. So I need a note taken to him. We need to escape the bonds of this negative energy. Like, together. Souls like ours should be spreading the love rather than being brought down with this deep shit, you know? We need to get out of here. I need you to tell him up there in the bewitching pool of highness that life is harsh down here, man. Just like it is up there. And it's time for us to take a trip and find a better place, you know? Can you do that for me?
Sure.
Radical. Here's a note to take to them. Okay, who exactly is them? I told you, man, my soulmate. We're one, man. We share the same soul. You'll know him when you meet him. You'll feel it within your soul. Names are labels that bind us like a prison. Release yourself, man, and look upon others as beings of light. Not as metaphors of confining definition. Whoa, confining definition. Confinition. That's deep, man. That's deep. You feel that? Oh, I feel something. Far out, man. Far out. Oh my god, I'm getting the fuck away from this guy. Jesus Christ. This trailer home has been decorated with dream catchers and wind chimes. It smells strongly of patchouli. I have no idea what that is. Hello. Ah, that's a normal safe, isn't it? A working tumbler. Well, yeah, you can't do normal lockpicking on that. Nope, I don't have safe cracking. Oh, hello. The townie. A shivering man mumbles to himself as he rocks in place. He clearly lost his wits. The wreckers are killing everyone! We're all going to die! Alright, well, I don't have Kiss Ass level 2, but Angela does have Hard Ass level 3. Pull your shit together, man. You should be doing the killing. You're right. You're absolutely right. For High Pool! Oh god, he's dead. He's so dead. I just killed him. Examining these pipes says, those are some big pipes.
Gonna need a bucket brigade at Town Hall! Fire's getting bigger!
I'm coming. Come up. Okay. But actually, I don't think that trap did any damage. It's not listed here, and I don't think anybody's health went down. Alright, cool. Okay. Nice little excursion. Oh yeah, wait a minute. What about the note? I should read the note. Yes. On Thursday, we leave for home. Oh. That wasn't as exciting as I thought it would be. Oh shit. Oh god. I hope they have unlimited health. I don't think they do. Nope, they don't. Oh, here we go. Shit. Ah, I wasn't quite done setting up. Have they taken any damage? Wow, so one of them died. I mean, one of our guys died, but it doesn't look like the enemies have taken even a single point of damage. They're all full. Thankfully, they're weak as hell, though. They got, like, 10 to 15 hit points. Alright, who am I controlling? Angela. Excellent. Out of range, out of range, out of range. Wonderful, let's get into cover. Can I get into cover and shoot twice? No. So, might as well move into some very good cover. She might be blocked here because of all these people standing to the sides. Let's go here. Gah! Nice. Alright. Well, my shots have been doing minimum damage, which means I probably won't be able to kill this guy in one shot. Let's try that again. I mean, it can't keep doing minimum damage, can it? Let's see. Is it gonna do 12 again? No, it did 15. Excellent. What the hell? What are you doing there? Alright. Well, got a shotgun. Let's fucking use it. Gonna destroy your cover, motherfucker! And, you know, I think they changed the system from how it was in beta. Because the way this used to work in beta, when I was playing it, is that you could actually control where the cone went, even while hitting the same enemy. So, for example, like, see right here, it's the cone is just has the enemy right in the center. It used to be that if you moved your targeting thing to the left, like this, then you could actually move the cone so that just the right side of the cone would be hitting him. Which meant that, you know, if enemies were kind of close, you can kind of fudge the angle a little bit and hit multiple enemies at the same time, but you can't do that anymore. Which fucking sucks. I don't know, there must be a good reason for it, but yeah, unfortunately that means I can't hit both enemies now, so, shit. Alright, I think this would destroy his cover, although I don't think it indicates it. But let's just kill this guy. Ambush. Oh, shit. Oh, it's fine. Ooh, oh, seriously? How do you miss with a shotgun from 10 feet away? It's okay. Yeah, you need to get him into some cover. Yeah, what the hell are you doing over here? You're in some big trouble. Ugh. Yeah. Alright, we got some serious AoE opportunities coming on with these melee guys. Hopefully I'm gonna put that shotgun to good use. Okay, I don't want to move forwards to flank these people, because then we're going to just move closer to the melee guy, so I think we should all just take cover and probably just ambush. Unfortunately, there's really not that much cover. I guess I'll take cover here. I don't know if I can shoot over this guy's shoulder. Not that there's anyone to shoot anyway. Let's just ambush. Oh, she's got a ton of AP. It'd be fairly safe to move here. No, I think I might be... Yeah, I'd probably be vulnerable to that person. Ooh, yeah, let's move here. Nice little ambush. I do want to ambush with her. But I also want to put her into cover. I think I have time to go into cover. I don't think there's anything that I need to really ambush against at the moment. The melee guys aren't too close. Alright, come on. Everybody's in cover, good luck hitting us. Haha, get wrecked! Nice try, Theodore. So yeah, I could just blast him, which I think would probably destroy his cover, although I'm not sure. Okay. Even though this cover looks dinky, it is actually just as good cover as this. Although I wonder if certain cover has more or less hit points. But, let's try this. Let's see how this works. Alright, it's the same chance to hit, really? Like, it's literally like, there's a box between you and the enemy, and you're going to... You're gonna aim your shotgun at the guy on the other side of the box, and you really only have a 36% chance to hit? Okay. Nice, Yulia. Good job. Ew. That was disgusting. There's no point in shooting. Just ambush. Come on. Oh my god, they're so vulnerable out in the open. Can you imagine the explosive here? Oh! Oh! I want to put Yulia to some good use. Lost control. No, as long as you kill somebody. Yeah, good job. If you lose control and kill somebody, I'm perfectly fine with that. Yeah, I guess I'll move them here. Got a fairly clear shot on them when they come here. They're too far away. If I moved up here, I might be able to hit two of them, but she'd be way too vulnerable. It's not worth it. I'm just gonna start blasting them. Wonderful. Alright, well next turn, thanks to the saved AP, I probably have enough to unjam and shoot once, I think. Alright, that's worth it. Nice. Too far. Ambush. Execute that ambush. Nice. Sweet. Nice. Okay, finally gonna get to put my sniper to use. Been itching for that. Can't kill this guy in one hit unless I get a crit. This guy can probably kill in one hit. Nice. No, I can't unjam and hit in the same turn. Damn it. Alright. Just hang out there, I guess. Wow, took two bullets and he's still not dead. That's right. This'll finish him off. I said, this will finish him off, Angela. Thank you. Yeah, he's a little bit too far away for a good shot. There's nowhere really good to move to that isn't super close. Like, that's too close. This would be good, but it's already full. I guess this is kind of closer. A little bit. Slightly. Nah, that's not worth it. I'll ambush. Oh, there we go. Nice. Aw. Alright, I think it's time to blast you in the face. Really? 34% chance to hit? What the fuck? This cover system is weird. Like, it doesn't seem to account for popping out. Which I think is kind of how XCOM worked, right? You would pop out of corners, right? Like, this would be as if I was shooting him from this square, because when she went to shoot, she would pop out. But I guess it just doesn't do that. Looks like if you're not shooting them from the position of where you're at being, if you know, if the position where your character is right now is not actually shooting them when they're out of cover, then I guess it just doesn't work. There is no popping over or popping to the side of something, if that makes any sense. Alright, what about this? Alright, that's better. Nice, it didn't do much damage, but it's pretty cool. Shooting would be a terrible idea. Let's move you here in ambush. Oh, here we go. Alright, so I guess I have to move out of cover if I want to actually hit him out of cover. Oh, right. Shit, I'm a little bit close. That takes 5 AP. Alright. May have been a bad idea. If I ambush here, I might shoot Yulia in the face. Let's move here instead. This fight's gonna be over before he gets back to his turn anyway. 30% chance, not worth it. Once again, I'm probably gonna shoot Yulia if I do that. Just move closer. Nice! Good job, Harper. I'm proud of you for that shot. That was a lot of enemies. And very weak enemies, but a lot of them nonetheless. Alright, let's get everybody reloaded. Let's switch you back to your main weapon. And we have 3 levels up. Hell yes. Let's loot the bodies first, I guess. Ooh, hello. It's a new assault rifle. Is it better than what I have? Let's see. Maybe. It's got a shitty name. It's literally called Rust Bucket. But 10 to 14 damage instead of 6 to 12. Nice. Hit chance is the same. Crit damage is the critical chance is the same. Crit damage is actually 0.1 more. Slightly higher chance to jam. Slightly smaller range. Much larger capacity. It takes more AP. No, there's no way. Because if it takes more AP, that means I can't shoot twice in one turn. That's not worth it. No. Not even for the increased damage. Alright, what's this sign say? Know your knots and how to use them. Always good advice. Alright, let's call in.
Copy, Echo 1. This is Ranger.
Report.
Echo
1, mm-hmm. Congratulations. Thank you. Okay. Yeah, I really want to spend in assault rifles because their chance to hit right now is just really bad. But I'm kind of neglecting the other things. It's fine. I'm just gonna spend the rest of the skill points for a while on lockpicking and computer science. That's fine. Yep, same for you. Upgrade your sniper, and then I'll focus on the other stuff after. You didn't level up. You did. Yep, shotgun. Alright, so yeah. Next levels for them, I'm gonna focus on non-weapon skills. Now you know. Wait, what's the sign say? Oh, that's a different kind of knots, isn't it? Overhand, something, something, cat's paw. You know, to be honest, I don't know jack shit about knots. I know how to tie my shoes. I don't even know if that has a specific name for that kind of knot, but yeah, that's about it. Hello? Can we talk? No? No. Thanks for saving our hides, Rangers. But there's more of them slavering beasts around.
One in the cheek.
Nice. Got so much pistol ammo at this point.
Guys, right. I can't do this alone. I think I just heard screaming down here. Are the wreckers in? Can anybody hear me?
Bergen, Commander Danforth. Anybody? Can anybody hear us? This is Harvard from the Scorpions. The guys you hid in the cave, remember? Bergen, there's something down here, man. It's after us. It already killed Dog Breath, and it's... Oh, shit! Run! Run!
The sound of chainsaws and servos drowns the scream of men and... fear and agony.
Screams. Something's going on down here.
Then deal with it, Kate. We're kinda busy up here.
Alright, things aren't good. I like all these little details here. People playing games. Hopscotch and whatnot. The fuck?
Trying to get a beat on that demolition crew, but their shooters are pinning me down! Anybody got an angle?
Oh, they're shooting from up there? Okay. Oh, we're gonna flank them. Nice. Alright. Let's get our people into place.
Get back! Get 12!
Actually, no, let's put my shotgunner up there. Let's put you here. Alright, that's okay. Not bad. I don't know if this counts as cover. Maybe? It might. Actually, this is where my sniper should be. Alright, let's go. Suppose I should make everybody crouch. There we go. Oh, come on, they all moved? Son of a bitch. I gotta relocate everybody. Alright, stand back up. Please don't initiate combat. That'd be very bad. I want Angela Death to be pretty close to the front because she has so much health. If you're here, I want a height advantage, so you should probably be here. You have range? Sight block, out of range, shit. Alright, how about here? Damn it! Alright, fine. I'll put you here. Alright, there we go. Now everybody crouch. Now we're ready to go. Let's see if there's any explosives around here. Don't see any. Side block. I like to shoot the people with the rifles first. But unfortunately, their sight is blocked, so. Screw it. Deadfall, alright, got some harder enemies here. Jackhammer, that would be... that's the woman with the hand, right? There's certainly something up with her hands, it's hard to tell what. One looks robotic. Nice, almost dead. One hit point left, damn it! Go down, you bastard! Alright. Oh my gosh, he's fast. Oh god. Oh god. No, not Harper! Oh, only 3 points of damage. Eh, that's not too bad. that's a very bad chance to hit. Maybe we should get a little bit further away. Yeah, let's get a little bit further away. There we go, much better. Oh my god. That only did 4 points of damage, holy shit. Move into a good position here. You know, I think I should stop crouching my characters, because I keep running into these situations where I can't move very far because of the fact that I've crouched them. At least I think that's why I can't move so far. It takes AP to uncrouch, right? Alright, well, I guess I can go for one. Maybe it doesn't take AP to uncrouch, because she's in cover? I don't know. Ah, I can almost hit two! Almost! So close! Well, these are both the same enemies, so let's just go for this one. Nice. Ooh, that hurt. Thankfully, it was Angela. I'm not too worried about her. Alright, we really need to take out... you know, I think we need to take out everybody but Jackhammer first, because she has so much health, she's going to take a long time. Let's take out the easy ones that do a lot of damage, like this Wrecker. Ah, same chance to hit. I don't think there's any point in shooting, let's just... could ambush. Nah, let's move here. Better. I could just bash him in the face. In fact, I probably should. That was pathetic. Oh. Good aim. Ow! Alright, at least she's spreading the pain. That's good for me. Okay, well, I can either try to flank and not be able to do anything this turn, or just work on Jackhammer. Let's just do that. Bleeding. Good. 9 points of damage, though, man. Okay, got some good shots here. Nice, nice, nice. Let's take you out. Almost. Okay. Our problems have minimized. Now we've only got two. They're big problems, but they're only two. Let's go for a headshot. That doesn't seem worth it. Maybe. I mean, like, over time, if you add it up, it is actually worth it. It's a minus 40% hit chance, but it does 200% damage. Right, I think if it was a minus 50% hit chance and did 200% damage, then over time it would equal the same, but as it is with only a minus 40%, I believe it means over time you'd actually gain more. Wait, whoa, whoa, whoa! I can aim headshot? Look at this, this is the aiming of the beam that I was talking about. Wait, 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 maybe they just changed the mechanic, hold on. No, how? Oh! Thank God I just figured this out. They didn't get rid of the ability to fudge the, and move the beam before you shoot. They just changed it to kind of a different location. So if you just aim at enemies without selecting anything down here, if you just do this normally, right? Then the cone only appears when you actually mouse over an enemy, but if you actually press the free aim, it even says. If you press free aim, then you can. Okay, that is really good to know. Wow. That's kind of awkward, the way it's split up like that. It's weird. Anyway, let's do a headshot. Nice. Lost control. Alright, come on, hit him good, hit him! Oh. Oh. She's concussed. Gotta take out this mall bastard. He doesn't have much health, but the problem is I just can't get a good angle on him at the moment. Just keep working on Jackhammer. Did you miss and then hit Maul? I guess so. Nice. Actually doing a pretty good number on Jackhammer. Should I move? Here? That doesn't seem like a good idea. Let's move here, and then ambush. Unless I can get a good shot? Nope. Okay, so now I can actually hit both of these people. If I move closer. Yes, there we go. This is the power of the shotgun. Oh, take him out. Nice, Harper. Good job. Bash her twice. Yeah. Let's do it. All right, you want to fight hand to hand? Let's do it. Nice. Oh, shit, Helen is apparently out of ammo to reload with. She's only got one sniper bullet left? Oh no. Holy shit, she's got 166 shots of pistol ammo. Whoa. Wow, I haven't been taking a look at these weapons, have I? Okay, that one's not... Oh, whoops. Wait, that one actually might be better. Holy shit, I didn't realize she had so many. Alright, well this thing's crap. I think that's what I had before. That's what I've already got. More damage. Same hit chance. Greater crit. Same jam. Smaller range, but, you know, I'm using a pistol at close range anyway. Ooh, takes more AP. How much AP does she normally have? 8? Yeah, 8. Which means she can't shoot 3 times with the other pistol anyway, so I might as well go with this, actually. Yeah. Old Navy revolver. Anyway, does anybody have sniper ammo? No. 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 And no. Well, shit. I guess she's gonna be using a pistol. Why are you swapping your weapon? I don't even have you selected. What is up with this? This keeps happening over and over again. Okay, I'm selecting Helen. 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 I've now selected Helen. Okay, there we go. Thank you. It's got a bunch of marbles. Yay, marbles. Lots of assault rifle ammo, but no sniper. Come on, let's take a ride. Hmm? Is there... what's gonna happen? Is there, like, some... lift thing? Hold on. You first, Angela. Ooh, hello. Perfect! Gonna have to see if that's better than what Helen has at the moment. Nothing back there. Yeah, there's also a container up here. What does this one say? It says might need to know this one later, but there's nothing on it. I guess there's supposed to be more types of knots or something. Alright, take a look at that sniper. Is that the one that I was thinking about buying? Let's see, it does... considerable amount more damage. Hit chance is the same when you consider the underbarrel flashlight mod that I have on this current one. That's the same, that's the same. Chance to jam is slightly higher. Range is actually higher, ooh. Oh, hell yeah. And it takes less AP, oh yeah. It does more damage, it has more capacity, and it has way more range. Yep. Alright, let's remove this attachment. Oh, there's a 50% chance it will be recovered, okay. So it's not guaranteed to be able to remove it. That's kind of weird. Like, are you so bad with tools that when you remove something, there's a 50% chance you're gonna completely break it? Like, jeez. Are you that bad with a screwdriver? And it was destroyed. Good job. Whatever. It's only like a, what, 2% chance increase to the chance to hit. I just realized that the rust bucket might actually be better for Angela. Because she has more AP, so I think she can get 2 shots off with this thing. There's a decreased range, but it's not that much of a decrease. Hmm. I don't know. That new sniper is sexy! Ah, I see. A grizzled man wrapped in a leather duster that's clearly been handed down from gunshot victim to gunshot victim, and a filthy t-shirt that has the word security written across the chest. The look of disgust he has stapled to his face seems permanent, even when he's smiling.
Well, all right, McNamara. Good job. Wait a minute. You're not McNamara. Who the...
Did they just cut off a sound file or something? He's like, who the...
Rangers? Rangers? Woohoo! Rangers! Our saviors! Well, I guess I gotta thank you for taking care of these clowns. Though you could have got here before they wrecked our irrigation system and killed our mayor.
I can tell you're an important character because you can actually talk.
You gonna go finish them off now? Or are you just here for our radio tower like you told Mayor Vikstrom?
No, we're here to protect and serve. Well, we would like to use a radio tower, but let's not worry about that now. Alright, who's this McNamara? Oh, now you're gonna stop talking, fine. Huh? Nobody. You wouldn't know him. Ooh, hard ass level 2. Well, it just so happens, Angela. Well, we want to know him. And you'll tell us about him, if you know what's good for you. Okay. No need to get rough. He's, just a guy who... You know, your Rangers aren't the only game in town. We haven't seen you for nigh on a year, and the Red Scorpions show up when we call them. At least, most times they do. Captain McNamara and the rest of the RSM have done right by us more times than you have, that's for damn sure. Okay. You trust them, the Red Scorpions? Hey, they're closer than you. And they don't try to solve problems by shooting little children. Wait, what the fuck? What the heck? Okay, let's follow that up in a second. Sure, we gotta pay them, but at least they work for their money. Okay, what the fuck do you mean shooting children? You say that, but I know the truth. You just stay away from our kids, Rangers. They're all we got in this shitty world. I won't warn you twice. What the hell? What is he talking about? I wonder if that's like a reference to something that happened in Wasteland 1. I can't imagine the Rangers shooting children. Alright, what happened to the mayor? Those wreckers... couldn't hit what they were aiming for if their lives had depended on it. Blech, let's try that again. These wreckers couldn't hit what they were aiming for if their lives had depended on it. But they got in a lucky shot yesterday and shot Mayor Vikstrom when they was aiming at me. Bloom clear off the wall. I've had to step in as temporary commander now Vikstrom's gone. But I aim to hold a vote and make it official as soon as things calm down. Then we'll have some real law and order around here. We won't have to rely on the Rangers for help anymore either. Tell me about this voting. Gonna have a show of hands in the town square once we get these wreckers dealt with and the irrigation fixed. Kate Preston thinks she's a shoo-in. But I'm the one getting things done around here. All she does is talk. I think the people will make the right choice. So you're the law and order candidate? You still think the Rangers are the only ones who can deliver justice in this world? She got another thing coming. Well, you got another think coming. Alright, well, he seems to have finished the wreckers. Not all of them, and the rest of them will be back for a reckoning. They'll be the end of us, unless you or the Red Scorpions take them out first. Personally, I'm inclined to ask the Scorpions to do it. They get things done. But if you want to try doing your job for a change, well, they must have a camp around here somewhere. Find it, and start shooting. That is, after all, what you do best. Ah. Cool. I wonder if I have to do that... Like, do I have to go straight from High Pole to that camp? Or can I go to the Ag Center and then come back to it? I probably have to go straight there. Alright, what's wrong with the irrigation system? I don't know. Maybe nothing. Kate Preston says a wrecking crew bomb smashed them valves, and is leaking like a sieve. She's been down in the tunnels trying to fix it since the attack started. I think she's just hiding from the fighting like the woman she is. Okay. Alright, tell me more about how sexist you are. I guess you already told me about pretty much what you think about Kate Preston, but tell me more. She thinks she's got the answer to everything. She thinks she's smarter than everybody else. Well, she's got the same problem the Rangers do. Whole lot of talking and not much doing. Got a problem with the Rangers, I guess we already established that, but see what he says. After your history with us, you're damn right we've got a problem with you. You're tolerated here, but you won't ever be loved. What history? I guess old Snake ain't too keen to teach his new recruits the truth about the Rangers' glorious past. Well, let me fill you in. 15 years ago, you fuckers came out here and shot a little orphan boy's dog. And then you shot the little orphan boy. My nephew, Bobby, who weren't armed with nothing but a BB gun. A BB gun! That's gotta be a reference to the previous game, right? Well, after that, Highpool only accepted Ranger protection because there was nobody else to turn to. Now there is. So you can go tell the General we ain't forgetting, and we ain't forgiven. And if he isn't careful, we ain't sending him any water no more either. The stuff about a BB gun reminds me of Fallout. I wonder if that's like a reference that's just been like passed through the original Wasteland to the Fallouts, and now also to Wasteland 2. Because I remember there was some stuff about a BB gun in Fallout 1 and or 2. It might have been in both. I think there's even a BB gun you could actually find and you could use it as a weapon. Huh. Wasn't it a Red Ryder? A BB gun or something? You talk like Highpool isn't in Ranger territory anymore. Well, are we? You'd think the Rangers would keep a better eye on the place that provides them with most of their water. If the Rangers don't want to protect us anymore, the Scorpions are thirsty too. Keep it in mind. Alright, tell me more about Bobby. Bobby's where the Rangers can't hurt him anymore. I visit his grave every day. And Rex's too. A dog and his boy. Together forever. That's a reference to the movie, isn't it? Wasn't there a post-apocalyptic movie about a dog and his boy? In fact, wasn't it actually called something like that? A dog and his boy? A boy and his dog? I don't know. Something like that. What happened to Rex? He's buried right over there. Right next to Bobby. Okay. I don't even know what this dialogue option is about. These clowns. What clowns? Who said clowns? Oh, I gotta thank you for taking care of these clowns. It'd be the Wreckers, right? Ah, yep, call themselves a Wrecking Crew. What do you know about the crew? Surprised you haven't heard of them. You being the law around here. They've been around for a year or so. Only mobile junkyard I've ever seen. Don't know why they got all aggressive all of a sudden. They've upgraded their weapons, too. Who has a jackhammer arm? How is that shit possible? Anyhow, they fucked us up proper. Not only did they kill the mayor and burn down our spring crop, but apparently one of their bombs smashed our irrigation system, too. Gonna take a while to get back to normal. What the hell's up with this jackhammer person? I've seen a lot of freaks come out of the wastes in my time, but I've never seen anything like her before. She had an arm like a jackhammer. How is that possible? Doc Warner couldn't do a surgery like that in a million years. Who's Doc Warner? Our local Sawbones. Me and the doc don't see eye to eye on a lot of things, but I owe him for a life saved, so I leave him be. He saved your life? Never mind about that, Rangers. It's not your business. About your radio tower. Thought as much. Rangers always think of themselves first. Hey, that was the very last dialogue option I chose. I thought of that last, you dick. In fact, I could even type in responses here on my own. I'm gonna say, you are a fucking dick. What do you think of that? Ain't got a clue. Of course. Rangers always think of themselves first. Well, we got an antenna up on the crane, but if you want to use it, you'll have to get it back online. There was some kind of short in the tunnels beneath the reservoir. See Kate Preston down there. She'll give you directions. If she ain't too busy fixing leaks.
Go on, then. Remind us why we agreed to your protection.
All right, maybe I will. Maybe I will. Yeah. I gotta keep a lookout for somebody to give a message to as well. That the hippie's soulmate, I guess you could say. Alright, well, this is a pretty good place to end the episode. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I will be back soon.